fresh face. It's cleanse, tones, moisturise and completely makeup free. So, I'm going to get dived right in. So the first thing I'm going to use is MAC Strobe Cream, and I love putting this on just before my foundation as I feel that it gives a really nice luminosity to the skin, and you'll see as I'm applying it, I'll get this nice kind of gleam to the skin, and I want this makeup to be really glowy. So I just feel like this is a nice base. If I want my nude base to be really luminous, I'll use the NARS Coco Cabana highlighter. But for just like a kind of everyday glow, I do like the MAC Strobe Cream. I feel like the MAC Strobe Cream is more hydrating as well. So all over the face. Okay, so that should give like a soft luminous glow to the skin. Now it's time to do the foundation. So the foundation I am going with today, as always, is my number one favourite. This is the Naked Skin Foundation by Urban Decay. Hands down, my favourite foundation. If you've been here for a while, you know that. And when I come away from it, I always go back to it. So Naked Skin. And the shade I'm using is 4.0, which is a yellow undertone. I must admit, I usually wear a 5, but just because it's January, it's still winter, I haven't been tanning as much. I'm finding the 4s actually working better for me. In reality, I'm probably a 0.5, which is the palest, but it's like white girl syndrome, we always want to be that little bit darker. So I'm just going to apply my Naked Skin straight from my palette, and I'm going to use the OPV Beauty Blender just to stipple it on. And it's the base of the Beauty Blender that I'm using. Naked Skin is a very buildable foundation, so you can really customise the coverage that you want with it. I like quite a full coverage obviously, so I will kind of stipple on that little bit more. And as I said, it's perfect for customising to the person that you're using it on, like if you're looking for a good kit foundation. I feel like Naked Skin is one of the best ones to keep in your kit simply because it does so many different coverage levels and it does so many different skin tones. Okay, so now I'm going to apply some concealer, and the concealer I'm using today is the MAC Studio Finish Concealer Duo. I didn't actually want a duo, but the colour I wanted was out of stock. So this was the W10 and NC20. I'll get use out of them both, but the lighter one, the W10, is probably the one that I... Well, you can see I've used that the most. This concealer is a great concealer. I used it for a long time before I switched over to Naked Skin. And recently, my colour in Naked Skin has been out of stock everywhere for my concealer. So I've went back to the MAC one just in the meantime. It's great. It's a good concealer. Great one for the kit as well. But I do prefer my Naked Skin Light Warm, I must admit, but it will do for just now. This is the Crown Brush C150 I'm using. And I'm just applying it to my under eye and taking it down into a sort of diamond. You'll all know that trick, just to kind of lift the eye rather than highlight anything that you're trying to conceal. So if you have bags or blueness, they usually cut around the eye. You don't want to do that. You want to pull it down onto the cheek and lift the eye. I'm going to have it on. I'll just beat it out with the Beauty Blender. So it's light, but it's nothing white. It's nothing draggy. I just feel like so many people at the minute think that it's kind of makeup acceptable to use white underneath your eye when you're pretty tanned, and I hate that look. I think as long as you keep it still a nice skin tone colour and not clown white, then it still looks beautiful, it still looks wearable. Okay, and now I'm just going to take the same concealer and pop a little bit down the centre, and this will give extra coverage and give a little bit of a highlight effect. I'm not taking any great skill, or I'm not putting any specific markings on. I find now that as soon as I put my kind of central highlight on, I buff it away as soon as I pop it on. I don't leave it to set. And I find that this gives a much more, again, wearable kind of soft contour effect without it being so heavy and cakey, or giving it a concealer time to set. If you buff it out straight away, it's a lot more sheer, it's a lot more beautiful. It's like real makeup, it's not Instagram makeup, it's like proper blended out and buffed out and beautiful. And then with the same concealer, just a little bit on the chin. And a little bit on the pout. And again, straight away blending out. So now I'm just going to add a little bit of cream contour, which is something I haven't done in a while. I'm just testing out the new Peaches and Cream contour colour, and I really like the way that they've brought out this range of new setting powders, highlighters and cream contours. They make sense for contouring in my head. There's not like loads of dark cream, loads of light cream. There's a nice mix of both. So this is the dark cream contour, and I'm just going to apply this in the hollows of my cheeks. I'm going to squeeze my beauty blender to apply it and pick up the cream product on the side of the sponge. And I'm just going to work it into the hollows of my cheeks. And as you can see, it's not crazy dark. It's very wearable, very blendable. And it just gives a really kind of gleamed out contour. There's nothing muddy about it. There's nothing heavy. It's still going to be very, very soft and hydrated. There's nothing cakey at the minute. Also going to work a touch of it onto the lower back jaw, and that will slim. And then a little bit up and round in my hairline. So there's no daft markings, there's nothing harsh about this. It's very strobed out still and beautiful, and it will just look amazing when we come to pick out all the highlight as well. Hey, this is the first time I've applied the Peaches and Cream product, the cream contour, to my face. I really, really like it. I feel like it's grown up contouring. It's nothing too heavy. It's something that's very dewy and beautiful, and it can be really buffed and blended. Again, that's just on the lower back jaw, and then round into the hairline. And for this look, I want my highlight to be really, really strong. I feel like because I powder and set my face, sometimes that when I put a powder highlighter then on top of the powder that I've set my foundation with, it kind of gets lost, and I don't get the same shimmer that I'm looking for in pictures that maybe I'm seeing in real life. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to not powder my face at the minute. I'm going to apply my powder highlighter, then I'll set the face. So my highlight today is a new product that I have, and it's the Anastasia Glow Kit and Gleam. I literally got these today and I am so stoked to use them. It comes in two. There's one called That Glow and one called Gleam. I think I'm going to go for the Gleam one today, and I think the colour that I'm going to go for is this one here called Starburst, which is very much my type of highlighter with a touch of a peachy pink coral through it. So the brush I'm going to apply it with is actually the Anastasia A23, and this was the one that they brought out with their first four large, highlighters. I'm just going to wet the brush with some Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray, and I always feel that when it comes to highlighter, that just gives a little bit more of a dewy strobed effect. And I also feel that if you do that, it doesn't stick to any open pores or any like soft bumps or anything that you have that you don't want to draw attention to on your face. So I'm just going to apply that on the high cheek, and it is quite intense, but that is what I want. I want it to be really, really strobed out so I can then blend it out with my beauty blender and set my powder over the top of it. So this colour is Starburst from the Gleam Kit. And it's pretty flaky. And I'm just putting it on the chin because I've got no blemishes or anything I'm trying to hide. On the nose, because that's my favourite bit. And on the pout. And then I'm just going to blend it in with the base of my beauty blender. And what I find that will do is it will just take away any seam marks or where it's meeting the foundation contour. So now we're like super strobed and super glowy, we're going to set that makeup. So I always set my makeup with the Urban Decay powder foundation, and this colour is Fair Neutral. And that tint, oh, I've been using this obviously to squish foundation into, but this colour is usually the one that I set my under eye with, just because I have went that wee bit lighter, but it's not white, it's a warm tone powder. And this is the Real Techniques contour brush that I use to set underneath my eyes. And I love this brush for setting concealer. I have literally like 5 or 6 of these because I've always repurchased them. And you'll see now that that is giving me a really matte effect underneath my eyes, but I'm still getting that beautiful strobed out glow from the Anastasia Gleam palette. Then I'm going to take the same powder foundation by Urban Decay, but in my skin tone colour. So this is medium light warm powder foundation by Urban Decay, and this is a Morphe M462, and I'm just setting the rest of my face with more like my skin tone colour of powder. I'm actually loving for this highlight right now. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a powder contour. I've done the highlight and we used that cream contour just to sculpt the face almost. But now I'm just going to use a little bit of almost bronzing powder over those dark sculpted areas that we had. I'm going to warm my neck up as well with the same powder, just so it's not so mismatched. And the bronzing powder that I'm going to sculpt the face with is the new Peaches and Cream bronzing powder. So this is a light medium bronzing powder. And the brush I'm going to use to apply that is my Nanshi brush. So this is the Nanshi brush. This is the Nanshi. I can't say it. This is the Nanshi blush brush. This just took me so long to say. So I'm going to use that. This is one of my favourite brushes. I love the Nanshi brushes. Why is that so hard to say? The Nanshi brushes. Yeah. So this is the Peaches and Cream bronzer. And again, this is the first time trying this today as well. Oh, that's gorgeous. That is so my colour of bronzer. I like things that have a kind of reddish tone to it. So overall, I'm really impressed with the Peaches and Cream contour cream and the bronzing powder. God, that is really nice stuff actually. Peaches and Cream do some amazing things. Like if you've never checked out their pigments, or these now are definitely a favourite of mine, I would definitely go and check them out because they're not expensive, totally affordable, And it's nice to see that they just started off as like a little salon in Liverpool and now they've got their own cosmetics brand. It's nice. So I'm just warming up my neck area as well. So now what I'm going to do just to sculpt out my contour is go back in with the Urban Decay Powder Foundation, and this was the Fair Neutral, so the light colour that I set my under eye with. And I'm taking the contour brush again, and just from my chin, I'm just going to sculpt out the contour and make sure that it's quite defined with that lighter colour. And I find that this is a really nice way of making sure your contour is super sharp and blended at the same time, without it being too draggy or too false or like racing car stripes. And then again, just with my beauty blender, I'm just gonna make sure that's a real seamless blend that I'm getting there. And I'm super happy with that. I just think that that is so much more wearable than these daft contours that I feel like everybody is going mad for at the minute. It's a trend that just doesn't seem to be going away in Glasgow especially. I just don't like white. I don't like anything that looks like you can see the contour or the stripe. It should be all super blended and super seamless and really dewy and glowy to me. I just think that's so much more attractive than having a mask of white or these racing car stripes down your face. But we've all been there. Just some of us have grown up faster than others, I think. Am I being really bitchy? I feel like I'm being really bitchy. None of my business. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and do my brows off camera. You've seen me do these a million times. I've got plenty of brow tutorials I can link below, and I'll meet you back here to finish this off. Okay, so I'm back with some brows on and we can get started on the eyes now. So I'm going to go in with the Urban Decay primer potion, and this is the actual anti-aging one. I usually use Eden, but if you've been a fan here for some time, you'll know that I sometimes suffer from psoriasis in my eyes, and I feel that the anti-aging one is a much better choice for me when I am going through quite a bad bout of psoriasis. So we'll just pop that on. And the trick with the Urban Decay Primer Potion is to not apply too much. It should be sticky but not overly saturated in product. I find especially with the anti-aging one, simply because it has that little bit of serum through it as well. And for me, once you've used Primer Potion, you can't go back without it. I know a lot of people like MAC Soft Oak or Paint Pot or MAC Painterly Paint Pot, but to me those are like cream shadows. Like, they still crease on me because I used to love using Rubenesque Paint Pot underneath my shadow, but I do feel that the Urban Decay Primer Potions are the best eye primers hands down, and it's something that I've not came away from since I started working for the brand. So they are a staple to me in anybody's makeup bag. Now I'm taking Urban Decay's Foxy eyeshadow, and that is going to be my base colour. This is the Nanshi shader brush that I'm using. And Foxy is a matte yellow tone. Favorite transition colors, and this is Urban Decay's Buck eyeshadow. It's the perfect kind of warm brown, but it's not so warm that it's orange, so it's still quite browny. And this is an angle-headed crown brush that I'm using, and I'm just popping it right in the crease, but then I'll take it up towards the brow bone. And I love this brush for doing really blown out, rounded, smoky eyes. I feel that because it's at a slant, it really can, it can make like such a beautiful rounded edge without it going too jaggy or too low and drippy. Now with the same colour Buck, I'm just going to run some of that underneath my lower lash line to make it nice and smoky. And that's just been the same brush, but I'm using the point of the brush rather than the actual fluffy part. Now I'm taking the Balm's Nude Chewed palette, which I really love this palette, but I feel like I don't reach for it that often simply because there's not a brow bone colour, there's not a crease, there's not, like, it's not set out like that. The colours are pretty like staple colours. So I'm going to go for the colour Sultry, which is the only one that I would be able to use in the crease really. And I'm going to apply it with my Morphe M441, which is one of my favourite crease brushes. And I'm just going to work a little bit more on blowing this out and the depth that I'm getting in the crease. Then I'm taking the colour Silly, which is like a chocolate colour with a bronze sparkle through it, and I'm going to do a lot of outer and inner work. I think we're going to make this quite a nice halo, smoky eye or spotlight, however you call it that, and I do just love that effect. I use it quite a lot. So I'm going to take the Nanshi crease. I think this is called the small crease. No, just a crease, but it's quite a small brush. It's not like a traditional crease brush, I find. And I'm just going to apply that on the outer corner first. So this is the colour Silly. And this is more little circular motions that I'm taking this time. And it's coming up and round and meeting the crease. And I'm just, if anything's looking too solid, again I'm taking my Morphe 441 that had the colour Sultry on it, and I'm just softening it down. With the same colour now, I'm just applying it on the inner corner. And that's what gives that spotlight effect that I'm a big fan of. And again, just on the lower lid, but in the inner corner, if that makes sense, all on the inside. And this bit is pretty intricate simply because it is a dark eyeshadow we're using here, so sometimes you can go a little bit off the beaten track with them. And they're a little bit less forgiving than say a highlight colour. But totally challenges you when you're doing like a round smoky eye to be a better makeup artist. It's easy to put sellotape on someone's eye. It's not so easy to find the proper places for the shadow position. And I'm just making sure everything really seamless, really blown out. I know when I'm bling bling. Ever since I left the city, you started going out and wearing less more. Less is the shit made out on our dance floor. Ever since I left the city, you Okay, so now I have that colour Silly all on and buffed out, we can go in and I think do something with this gap of spotlight that we've left. So this is the fleshy part that just still has primer on it. Now for me, I always go back in and strengthen up the spotlight. So today I'm going to use the Jumbo Pencil in Milk by NYX Cosmetics. So I need a new one, mine's just really small and I haven't sharpened it in a while, but I'm going to just break the head off it like I always do, or use it straight from the pencil. And this is a MAC 140 brush that I'm using to apply it. And I'm just literally taking it right in the centre. Have most of the white concentrate in the immediate centre, I would say. And don't take it too high, and don't take it too far into the chocolate sides that we have here. Now I'm actually going to continue the spotlight through the eye. So I'm going to actually apply a little of this underneath in the center as well. Okay, so once you put that on, I'm just taking my pinky and blending it out slightly because obviously the edges are quite harsh, so we don't want that. I'm just blending it into what we already have on the eye. So I'm going to use one of the nude peaches and cream pigments, and this one is called Kitten, and it's like a nude pink iridescent loose pigment. And as I said before, I love the peaches and cream pigments. So I'm just applying it with a Morphe M408 and packing it on top, and they do not disappoint. It's actually quite similar to MAC's Pink Opal, but a little bit more pink, I would say, rather than white. And they work just so well on top of that NYX pencil. And then now what I'm going to do that I've packed that on is I'm going to soften those edges just with the colour Sultry again. And this will also give like a 3D element to the blend that we're doing. It's quite nice not to have the pink meeting the colour Silly so abruptly. It's nice to have Sultry just kind of as the middleman breaking those up. And it doesn't need to be a lot, just a wee bit, because you don't want to lose the specialness of that pigment. But if you do take away too much, you can always go back in and make it stronger. I tend to do that anyway. Okay, so now we've got that on, I'm going to make this super smudgy and smoky. So with the same Nanchi crease brush, this time though, I'll be taking the colour Sleek, which isn't the black, but it's like this really deep, deep chocolate brown. And I think it will complement the look more than, say, a black would. And I'm just doing those outer edges. It's actually pretty intense for a brown. I really like this palette. Going on the inner corner now with the colour Sleek, which is that dark chocolate brown. So now just to give the brow bone a little oomph, I'm going to take a little touch of the Milk pencil on that MAC 104 again, and I'm just going to put some in the high point of the brow. And try not to make that chunky. You literally want to put that on and blend it down slightly. And again, this is much more wearable and effective than plastering the whole eye in the white jumbo pencil. And what I'm going to do now is take the Nude Chewed palette again by The Balm, and I'm going to apply some of that colour Sassy, which is a pearlescent white. I'm going to just pop that on top of the jumbo pencil. Now you need quite a flat brush for this, so I'm taking my Urban Decay Naked brush. So these are the ones that you get with the Naked palette, and they are great brushes. And I'm just popping some of that Sassy. Now you can see that it's quite intense, so make sure so that you're not kind of taking anything away from that gradient blend, that I'm just taking the brush that I applied Foxy, my base colour, on and making sure that that's meeting that blend and it's not so Patch Butcher-esque. I don't want to detract away from the spotlight whatsoever, and I must admit I'm not the biggest fan of liquid eyeliner these days. So I'm going to go straight in with lashes. Now the lashes I'm going to apply are a set of peaches and cream lashes. And I've had peaches and cream lashes before, but these ones in particular I don't think I've had before. And these are number 9s. Actually, I think I have had these before, but they're super wispy and I think they're very rounded, so they're going to complement the look well. So we're going to use these. So now that I have some lashes on, I'm going to load them up with some Maybelline Great Lash, which is a great mascara. So it literally is just going to blend my own eyelashes. Not that there's many left. I literally have nearly lost every eyelash on this eye because of psoriasis. But people power through. Thank God for falsies. And I'm just going to blend up my shitty little psoriasis riddled lashes up into these beautiful big feathery number 9s from Peaches and Cream. And I always apply mascara after the lashes. I just find that it looks a lot better. So I've got a new colour for my lips rather than just a dark red or a nude, which I feel like I've been so stuck in a rut with. And I bought it the other day in the airport. I'm going to just put on my liner first, which is Urban Decay's Deep Liner, which is one of my favourites. So I've got Deep On by Urban Decay, and this is the colour I was talking about that I got in the airport, and it's a matte, and it's Please Me by MAC, and it is the most beautiful shade of pink, and I just think their really dark tan lip line, baby pink, works so well. And this is not going in my kit, this is my lipstick, hence the reason I'm using it right on my lips. Too many lipsticks that I buy get given to the kit. This is staying with me. And just to give the lips a little bit of dimension, I'm going to take some of the Milk pencil and just ombre it in the centre of the MAC Please Me. And I think we're done.